Hi YouTube, it's Molly, and today I'm here with a very, very late response to a conversation that went around, I want to say about 3 months ago, about food addictions and weight loss surgery patients. And at the time I wanted to weigh in, and what prevented me from doing so was that I was still pre-op, and even though I had ideas about I don't want to say stance because it's not really opinion. If I was a food addict or not, I really wanted to see how life was post-op and how I reacted to confirm that I wasn't a food addict. And watching a lot of videos, you see a lot of different ideas on like what a food addict exactly is. By most of the definitions that people use, I would not consider myself a food addict. And from the way that I've reacted to everything post-op, I definitely believe that that's the case, that I wasn't a food addict. A food addiction was not the reason I'm overweight. Really bad choices and seeming to have an endless stomach where I could eat and eat and eat and not be full was probably the problem. I think that there definitely are people who do have food addictions, but I don't think I was one. And there's a few reasons why I don't think that I was a food addict. I don't have this food is not constantly on my mind. It never was. It wasn't like where people talk about where they eat breakfast and they're already thinking about what's going to be for dinner and worrying about that or thinking about that, whatever it is. I don't ever think I did that. If food was presented to me, yeah, I ate it. And I didn't think about, oh, well, this isn't the best choice. Or, you know, if I sat down with a pack of Oreos, there was a good chance I was going to eat a lot of them. So, no, I didn't make good choices. But I don't think it was a food addiction. Food is good. I enjoy it. But it wasn't something that constantly was on my mind that was, you know, hanging over me. And to go along with this, I wanted to talk a little bit about how post-op has been for me with regards to food and the emotions and everything else that everybody talks about. I hear a lot of people talk about these overwhelming cravings and wanting to eat. I don't have that. I can't say that I've had a single craving since surgery. There was one day last week where I was like, wow, I could really go for an Oreo. That lasted about 5 minutes. I ate some PB2, and I was good. I don't consider that a craving. Like, if I got that Oreo off of my mind in 5 minutes, that, yeah. So, and I hear a lot of people having cravings and this and that. Hasn't influenced me at all. And emotional eating, another one that, you know, people say they want to turn to food and now they can't. I haven't really wanted to turn to food at all. I'm full and I'm happy, I'm good, I'm done. You know, I don't know if I want to put it as lucky or if I want to put it as I mentally prepared myself well for this and made this decision and I knew that that's what life was going to be like and I'm good with that. You know, I don't know if it's really preparation, if it's really the fact that I didn't have food addiction. I don't really know exactly what it is, but I don't have these like overwhelming emotions about not being able to turn to food and not be able to eat what I want and put what I want in my mouth or that I want more. If I eat my 2 ounces and I'm full, I'm not sitting there going, I really, really wish I could eat more and trying to shove more in. I'm full, I'm done, and I'm good. That's why I had the surgery, was to have that full feeling that I really didn't have that often pre-surgery. So I guess my point being is not everybody has those feelings and those cravings that I hear a lot about. And I'm thankful for that. I'm glad. And it's hard to think what would be different about my journey if I did have those cravings and I did want to emotionally eat and couldn't, and just didn't know how to deal with things because I didn't have food anymore. But I think that goes to show that really preparing yourself mentally and going to therapy or whatever it is if you need before surgery to prepare yourself is really, really critical. Because those of you who do have food addictions, I can imagine that losing the food is going to be a problem. But yeah, I just wanted to share my experience because it's not one that you hear a lot. You don't hear a lot of people say, no, I don't have cravings, and no, I don't want to shove more in my mouth, and those kinds of things. It's not as prevalent, and I don't know if it's because I'm the only crazy person who really just is happy with eating 2 ounces and feeling full and being done, or if it's just because nobody talks about it. I might just be a crazy one. So I feel like there's one other thing that I wanted to say in this video, so I'm kind of lagging here trying to think. I know I'm gonna remember what it is as soon as I end this video. But yeah, I just wanted to share a little bit of the other side. And I seem to, at least if I'm not the only one, be a bit of a small minority. But there are those of us out there who don't have crazy emotional issues with losing food. And if you're looking into surgery, you might be scared by those things that you hear. I know I was. I was thinking, I thought I knew myself, and I knew that once I had that full feeling, I'd be good and I was done. But at the same time, you hear all of these things about all of these reactions people have, and these cravings, and wanting to put food in your mouth, and not having that outlet to turn to. And I was like, wow, am I, really going to be like that? Maybe I just don't realize how I have a relationship with food. But now, post-surgery, I feel like I can really honestly say, no, I didn't have a food addiction. I didn't really emotionally eat. If there was food, I would eat it. It might not have been great choices. In fact, 99% of the time, it was horrible choices. And I think that between the bad choices and just having a ginormous stomach that could eat and eat and eat was probably the reason I'm obese. That, and most likely hereditary too, everybody in my family. So that's my account for the night. I'm incredibly happy and blessed that I don't have these issues, and I really feel for all of you that do. So that's all. I guess I'll talk to you guys soon. Have a great night.